Hey guys, so I have a haul for you today. It's a little bit of everything. Figured I would just show you all right now. I hope you enjoy it. The boxes I always think are gonna come so much bigger when you order a lot of stuff from Sephora, but this one, I don't know, it's like small. It's not what I expected, but at the same time, makeup doesn't take up that much room, but I got so much that I thought, maybe, but yeah. There's lots in here. I also have my Ipsy bag in here. I figured I would just unload what's in there. So I'm going to start with the stuff that I got from Sephora. So first I went into the store. I actually went into Sephora. So I have a little bag because I wanted to get a concealer. And I got the new Tarte Rainforest of the Sea Aqua Concealer. And I got this in Light. And I actually used it today. Literally, the applicator on this is so humongous. When I first saw it, I was like, this is huge. It reminds me of, if you guys remember the Wonder Woman lipstick or lip gloss that came out from MAC, how it had like the biggest applicator. I feel like this one's either the same size or bigger. I feel like it might even be bigger, but. I got that. I'm wearing it today. I've worn it actually a couple times because I went into the store to try it, so they put it on me then, and I don't know, I really like it. It's sitting really nicely on top of my foundation that I have on today, so I'm really happy with that. Then next, I guess we'll go into the lipsticks that I got. I got quite a few. I'll throw the Jeffree Star in there, even though you can't get that at Sephora. So I'll start with what I got from Anastasia Beverly Hills. So first I got her liquid lipstick in Craft. I actually got these two Anastasia liquid lipsticks for my mom. So this one's in Craft. It's so beautiful. I've tried it on in store and I love it. And since she's gonna have it, if I wanna use it, I can. And then I also got Sad Girl, which is another deep color, but it has like that gold or silver or red reflect in it, but it dries matte. It's so dark here, I don't know. Let's see if I can get you to see it. But it's a beautiful color. Again, it's for my mom and it's right up her alley. Now moving on to what I got for myself in liquid lipsticks. I got a couple that I hadn't tried before. Actually, all of them I haven't tried, but I have tried Kat Von D's formula before. I have Lolita. And this one is Bow and Arrow. And it just looks so beautiful. And it's supposed to be really good. It's so much more brown than what I'm comfortable with, but I don't know. I'm gonna try it for like a summer evening or something. I just think that this one will be really beautiful. Yeah. Then I also wanted to try one of the Stylist Day All Day liquid lipsticks. I got this one in Bellissima, and it's like a, from what I can tell from the packaging, it's like a peachy color, which is beautiful because I don't have any peachy colors yet. Okay, so it's more of a peachy nude. But it's beautiful. I am so excited for the summer to try this one. And then finally, it's actually what I'm wearing on my lips now, the Jeffree Star liquid lipstick in Androgyny. I was so excited when this came in. Oh my goodness. I literally got it yesterday, had this event today, and was like, hey, bye, need to wear it. It's beautiful. I love it. I've eaten and I've been gone for most of the day, and it has lasted the whole time. It still looks pretty much exactly as when I left. And I put it on before I put my mascara on today, because I was so excited. I almost forgot to put mascara on before I left the house. I was so excited to use this. They wear so well. I did not think they were like this was going to wear as well as it did. It glided on. It felt like water. It wasn't like moussey. It felt like water. I thought I had way too much on it at first, but then it dried down so well. I just used a pencil in a similar color to go around the edges while it was still damp to get them really nice and crisp. Oh, I'm in love. I'm in love with this. I need to order all of them. I really want what's it called? I think Drug Lord is the white color. I want that one so bad because I feel like it would just look so nice just placed on the center of the lip with any color, which is, I'm in love. I love this color. It was probably my favorite purchase. Okay, next I got the Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Definer. I've tried the Wiz Brow, and I didn't like it all that much, but the Definer, when I see people use this, and they're just like, voop, voop, three lines later, brows look done, and I'm not into the like super structured brow, maybe they are today, I don't know. I normally go for a very natural brow, but the shape of this just got me. Like, I'm in love with this. Haven't tried it yet. I was going to try it today, then forgot and restored back to my dip brown, Nash Brown, which is fine. But if this works out well, like, I'll just whip it on, and if it looks more natural. I also love the spoolies on the end of any brow pencil of the It Cosmetics, like Universal Brow one or whatever. And it's just something about how short it is and how it just gets through every single hair. And I love this product. I love the idea of this product. I haven't used it yet. I hope I got the right color. I got medium brown because I have fairly dark hair and fairly dark brows, so I want to make sure that I'm all for like go a little bit lighter, but everything about me is dark, so if I go light, it wouldn't work. Moving on, I got quite a few palettes. So I got some that I've been coveting for a while, some that I've bought for people as gifts and just never got for myself because I was like, no, I'll get it for them, and like I don't need it because I have so many other things. I'm making so much noise. I have so many other palettes, like contour and eyeshadow, and do I really need it? And then the sale came around and I was like, I really need it. So starting with Tarte, I got the Tarte Showstopper Clay Palette. I used this today. I loved it. The colors were amazing. It comes with Park Avenue Princess as the bronzer in the palette, Champagne Pink, Fame, and then six eyeshadows. And it's just beautiful. Like, it's all neutrals. I figured this would be really good for the summertime. I say like I wear a lot of makeup in the summer, like unless I have an event, like a wedding or something. Like I'm the type of person where like my day to day will be liquid eyeliner, mascara out the door. The next three things that I got in terms of palettes are from Kat Von D. I have her Kat Von D Monarch palette. Love it. Absolutely love it. Didn't think I was going to. I was like, oh, I don't know. I really like her eyeliner. It's my favorite eyeliner, but am I gonna like the palettes? And I was so upset over Christmas when I didn't get the My Vita Loca palette, like the record styled one. So upset. I was like, you know what? I'm getting what I want now. So I did. The first thing I got was the Shade and Light palette. This is the one that I was saying I bought it as a gift for someone, and I was like, oh, I don't need it. Like, I have other contour palettes. I have like a BH contour palette, but it's mostly blushes, but I used this today. Loved it. Oh, I don't know if you can tell, but I loved it. I only used these two colors. No, yeah, these two colors here. I didn't use the banana shade because I'm afraid of banana shades. I don't know, I have the NYX contour kit, and I've used the one in there, and I don't like what it does to my under eyes. I'm more of the just put some translucent powder on there that's a little bit lighter with a lighter concealer and you should be good to go. So I don't know about the banana powder, but I'm excited to try the one in this because it's supposed to be really good. I haven't tried the Anastasia contour kit. I have used it, but I don't own it, and I've never used it on myself, but it is also supposed to be very good. But for now, we're gonna work on this one. then, to go with the Shade and Light palette, I got the Shade and Light eye palette. Can you read? There we go. I used this today as well. All three of the palettes I used. I only used one color in this. Yeah, I only used, what is it? Solace? Solace? Like S-O-L-A-S? Solace? It's a deeper, darker chocolate brown right here. Like, look at that! Oh, it's so monochrome. I love it. I love the white. The white is honestly, if I'm being perfectly honest, the white and the black are the reason why I wanted this palette so badly. Because I love the look of that, like, matte, like, not chalky, but it's just, it's an eye that's a cut crease with white, and it's so, like, black and white. Oh, I want to do it so badly, and now I have this palette, so I probably will. Let me know if you guys want to see that as, like, a tutorial or something. And maybe I'll practice it and do that, or maybe I'll just wing it and film it and see how it goes. But I got those, and to go with the Shade and Light theme, I decided, why not go all the way and get the Shade and Light contour brush and case. Comes with a case. I literally got this for the brush. I just really wanted the brush. So this is my first time opening it. By the way, today is Sunday and I got this package on Tuesday, and I've had all of my exams this week for university, so I haven't touched anything until today. So that is willpower if I've ever seen it. Oh, I'm so excited. I haven't even touched this yet. I have not touched this. I touched it in the store, but you know how it's kind of grimy because people touch it all the time. Oh my gosh, the case. Oh, look at it. Look at how excited I am. Okay. Ooh, those like crushing things. Tip, I'm gonna throw this in the makeup drawers because it keeps everything smelling fresh and dry. I used to think they were frog eggs when I was little. If you open them and put them in water, they look like frog eggs to me. Oh my gosh, look at this. Like, it's not like expensive feeling, but it just looks beautiful. And that's all that I really care about. And I'm mostly more concerned with how the brush performs, if I'm really being honest. Why isn't this opening? Oh. There we go. Oh, smaller. And I thought, maybe because everyone touches it in the store, but here, I'll show you inside the thing. It just, like, there's nothing special but the case, really, but it just sits in there, little coffin. So this is, like, not as powdery, like, I don't know, maybe, I don't want to be like, I was so excited, now I'm disappointed. I'm not disappointed. This is a beautiful end. I wanted this for setting under my eyes, but the contour, like, the angled brush, I'm a little disappointed with the fluffiness, but it's gonna fit really well, so we'll have to wait and see how this performs. I'm in love with this side already, like just touching it, this side, soft and everything, but it's not as fluffy as I wanted it. To be fair, I should probably beat it up like Jaclyn Hill does a little bit. The last thing that I've gotten was the Sephora Z palette, because I have a bunch of drugstore shadows that are in like quads and stuff that I really want to depot. So this is what it comes with, which is the little magnetic things to put on the back of the eyeshadows, which is awesome, or blushes, whatever you want to use. And then it comes with this little Sephora thing. Oh, I guess it's to like pop the shadows out. Like, but that's actually really handy because all the time I have shadows in things that I'm like, I just want to pop it out. This is perfect. I mean, yeah. I'm really excited to start depotting. I think this, I mean, it's much smaller than what I thought. I thought that for some reason this was going to be the same size as the regular Z palette, but it's smaller. But it's not as small as the small Sephora Z palette, which is like half the size of this, but it's a pretty good size. It's, if you compare it to the Shade and Light eye palette, it's maybe 2.5 centimeters off of being the same length, but I'm happy with it. Realistically, I don't need anything bigger than this. If they had the big one in stock, I might have gotten it, but this one's good because I can still keep it in my top, like, eyeshadow drawer, so if I want to grab it and just have, like, essential eyeshadows in here, I will. This will probably be really good for traveling. I have some Coastal Scents and Morphe shadows that will fit nicely, like, in here, so if there are certain colors, I'm just like, I need a good transition shade, I need, like, a white, and I need a little bit of a shimmer if I decide to spice it up a bit, and that's all I need, and then I can put a blush in here if I depot a blush, and then I can be like, great, I'm good for the weekend, because that's all I'll need. That's never how it goes, is it? No. I'm saying this like, oh, I'm gonna be so conservative packing my makeup. Never. Never. Who does that? No one. I don't have the self-control for it, so that's fine. But I'm really happy with that. That's everything that I got from Sephora, but I also have some stuff that I bought from Bath & Body Works that I figured I would just show you guys really quick. Yeah. So I got 3 body lotions. Oh. And Love and Sunshine, 1000 Wishes, and Japanese Cherry Blossom. I just needed some. It's summer. Oh, I have the body wash for this too. I'll move on to the body washes then to go with it. This one has the same scent. It's really nice. It's like more of a darker evening scent. So I have Pink Chiffon, 1000 Wishes, and Energy Orange Ginger. I have these ones. So that's everything I got from Bath & Body Works. And then I actually got a package from Amazon. I used this today finally for the first time. I got a like steel makeup palette. You can see I used it because I have my foundation on there. Hi guys. But yeah. And it comes with a little spatula thing, which will be good for like depotting and stuff, I think. I won't really use it for mixing. And then finally I have my Ipsy bag. So I figured might as well just open this. I did use one of the items that I got in the Ipsy bag. That is the that is the Luxie 522 tapered highlighter brush. I used it today for my highlight. Oh yes, slay. I loved it. I was originally going to use this for setting, but because I got the Shaded Light contour brush, I figured I would use that side for what I was going to use this, because they're kind of a similar shape. You put them side by side. This one's actually more tapered, so this one I feel would be better for like the banana like shades and that for setting under the eyes. You can just see it sits just a little bit better in the corners. But I got 2 actual makeup products. So I got the Tarte Wonder Lip Surgeons. I like these. They smell minty. It's a beautiful color. I think it'll be really nice for the spring and summer. And then I got the Trust Fund That Glow Though highlighter. I thought this was coming. I thought this was gonna be in a round container. I don't know why. Don't know why that's what I had in my head. But I haven't opened this. Any of the other stuff I haven't used. Oh. It is in a round thing, but the box itself is square. It's interesting. So that's what it looks like. And then you take the top off and it's like in a little lipstick thing. It's like a really gold, pink, champagne goldy color. I'm really happy with this. It doesn't smell like lipstick. I thought for some reason, like, you know when you see something and you have to twist it up, it's like it would smell like lipstick. It doesn't. It has a really like light smell. It doesn't smell good. It doesn't smell bad. It smells like light chemicals, but not chemicals. I don't know how to describe it, but I'm really excited to use that. I don't actually have any cream highlighters, so I think that'll be really interesting to use, and I think it'll match Champagne Pot pretty well. Then I got the Jorelle Parker Fango Mud Therapy. It was the original Fango Mud Therapy with sweet almond oil, avocado oil, green tea antioxidants, volcanic ash minerals used on face and body. And this product is 100% vegan. So that's what it looks like. Let's see what it smells like. Oh, it has a little thing on it. I'm not gonna open it then. This is a good size though. Like, it's a good looking size, and then it's full to about here. So there's this top area of air, obviously, because you need to be able to travel and like package it. And then this, I'm actually super excited when I saw that I got this just now. It's the Moroccan oil treatment. It's for all hair types. I would normally put a serum or something like an oil on my hair in the morning, especially right after I strain it, but I was running a little bit behind today. So I think I'll try this. I also, when I opened my Ipsy package, I could smell this. Like, this is all I could smell, and I was like, what is that smell? And then I opened it and was like, oh, that's what it is. So I'm just gonna take like a little, like I just put my finger on the cap and tipped it over like that. This is like super like soft. I'm just gonna put it right through the ends of my hair. I really like how this is going in my hair. It disappears too. Like, you know, sometimes you get an oil and it sticks to your fingers more than it sticks to the hair. This really took to my hair. My hair is very thirsty, so I'm gonna put a little bit more on. I'm just gonna do another one of those bottle. Warm it up in my hand. Work it right. I like to concentrate like so much at the ends. I don't even like to bring it up to my roots really. Anything below the ear is fair game. Anything above it, don't touch it. That's everything though. I'm really excited to try all the products. If there's anything that you want to see a tutorial with, whether that be the liquid lipsticks, one of the brushes, if you just want to see how the brushes work, the palettes that I got, please feel free to leave a comment or a request. And if you liked my video, please go ahead and subscribe. Okay? Thanks. Bye, guys.